Charles.
So there are some pictures of Amir Khan that surfaced on the internet, and a lot of people are talking smack. Brandon Krause is not one of them.
Very light, please. Punch, punch, block, block, close.
Brandon, a lot of people talking smack about Amir Khan, unjustifiably so. The guy's not fighting. He doesn't have a fight coming up. Okay. And they're ripping him. And you looked at those pictures and said, Ellie, what are you talking about? He looks fine to me. Looks normal.
Well, you know, but boxers don't look normal. Boxers look
yeah,
like
superheroes.
Yeah,
but that's on fight night. Does he have a fight tomorrow night?
No. Look, for Joe Schmo, it looks like an in-shape guy, right? But for Amir Khan, yeah, he looks out of shape for Amir Khan.
But you said he only looks like 160.
Who looks spectacular in the ring, you know? A guy that looks like a bodybuilder.
But I'm saying, if he's 160 now, it's no problem losing 13 pounds in 3 months, 4 months, if he's fighting in the end of December?
Yeah, no, typically this is the modus operandi of boxers, that they'll gain, you know, 10% higher than their fight weight and then lose it come the fight camp.
A lot of people saw the pictures and were like,
some guys lose a tremendous amount of weight.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that a lot of people's reaction to the pictures were like, wow, look at Khan, and your reaction was, Ellie, I don't see what the big deal is.
Well, look, it's all a matter of perspective. For somebody who follows boxing and knows Amir Khan, yeah, like it looks like a different guy. For Amir Khan, for his level, he's a lot softer than you're used to seeing him. But for Joe Schmo, what's the guy? He's got like 12% body fat, which is considered healthy.
Yeah, but also my point is, that's the case, except for Klitschko and Mayweather, the only two guys that are 24/7, 365, every fighter on the planet looks like that when they're not fighting. They look normal, they look human. On fight night, they just drain themselves. They lose the 10 pounds, 12 pounds, 15 to 20 pounds.
Ellie Sekbak obviously is not preparing for a fight.
No, I'm not. And Brandon Krause isn't either. If you were, you'd probably weigh 126 right now.
135.
135. What do you weigh? What's your walking weight?
145.
All right, so you have to... Where are you going to lose those 10 pounds from?
For me, it's all water. I don't have anything to lose.
So what do you do if you have to lose the weight?
I haven't had to lose the weight in quite some time, but really just super hot bath or a sauna if I can have access to a sauna, but usually don't, so I have to settle for really hot bath.
And that gets rid of the water weight?
Yeah, sweat. I mean, literally, like, you just sweat out the water. You know, that's on top of eating zero and clearing out your GI tract.
Do you get cramps when you lose weight like that?
I don't bring it to such an extreme where that happens, no, but I mean, some guys that have to lose a tremendous amount of weight have to go through all sorts of hardships.
Okay, Amir Khan against Kell Brook, what do you think?
Oh, I think Amir Khan should be the favorite in that, the more established guy. Kell Brook is the guy who's been saying that he's worthy for a long time and finally proved it in his last fight. And now he's saying he's worthy of fighting him, Amir Khan. And guess what? He's worthy of fighting him, and maybe he'll be worthy of beating him too.
All right, there you have it. Brandon Krause here, here at Outlaws. FaceTheReport.com. I'm Ellie Sekbak reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter @SekBak.